comrade. 3 o'clock this afternoon, Saturday, May the 1st. The General Council of the Trades Union Congress has announced that unless an acceptable settlement of the miners' grievances is reached beforehand, a general strike will commence!
Hey, what is going on, guys? It's the Alice Project here, and welcome to Hearts of Iron 4 Kaiserreich mod. And as most of you guys probably already know, direct rule from London won the vote. So I'm somewhat sad I won't be able to play American Union State, but regardless, I like playing some Oswald Mosley. So without further ado, we shall get into the game. If you can hear in the background, I have some of the I have the Kaiserreich soundtrack mod, but I've put it very low because I want to try and avoid copyright as much as I can. Now, we are playing as Union of Britain, and I haven't played as Britain in a while. Union of Britain, what happened? How did it become like this? Well, obviously, they have lost World War I. Not as bad as France, though. Britain peaced out, peace with honour. They've basically just said, enough is enough, we should get out. However, that has sunk the United Kingdom, or Great Britain, into a huge, large-scale depression, economic depression, of course. The revolution of 1925 happened, where the, was a general strike of the miners in Wales, turned into a full-blown revolution. Ulster got munched up by Ireland under Michael Collins, obviously. And now we have this thing, Union of Britain under Philip Snowden for now. Ruled by the Trade Union Congress, I think, if I'm not mistaken. So obviously, we are going to start with the 1936 Congress of the Trade Unions. This year's TUC will probably be a bit special. Long-time chairman Philip Snowden has indicated that he intends to resign. Obviously, he's fairly old. The decentralationists, autonomists, led by Niklas E. Gleiss, centralizationists, maximists by Oswald Mosley, and status quo federationists led by Arthur Horner, with his egalitarian and pacifist running mate Annie Keeney, are all vying for superiority. These will be knights to remember. So, who are they? Federationists, Arthur Horner, I think he always dies, if I'm not mistaken. And then Keeney takes command, and she's like really pacifist. They literally don't do anything. So, Britain is kind of in shambles, and we need to get it up and running, just like Mosley wants it to. So, we shall first build a couple civilian factories, and then start working on armament factories up here in the north. We have 20 civilian factories. We're going to put 10 on this. We're going to put 5 on support and 5 on towed artillery. And so far, we're going to produce destroyers in a large amount. I'll put them in London. Alright, I need oil. I shall trade with Iron Guard Romania. Because I don't want to trade with the US just now. And obviously all these divisions, we're just going to put them under a single army for the time being. Who do we have? John Worker, Alan Brooke, Bernard Montgomery, Richard O'Connor, John Dill, and Jufadle Kusne-Martel. Okay. Well, obviously we have Monty right here, but since this guy's a field marshal, I'm just going to put him for the time being, obviously. That is okay. Let's proceed. Now, obviously, we've read all this. Thank you. Great. Yes. What did I want to say? Okay, first of all, let's read this and I'm going to proceed. New Britain. After the defeat of France, the United Kingdom's war with Germany dragged on inconclusively for 2 years. In 1921, the stalemate was finally broken when Lloyd George agreed to the German proposal of a peace with honour. While Britain's overseas territories remained largely intact, the faith of the people did not. In 1925, disaster struck. A minor labour dispute in the coalfields of South Wales quickly escalated, and after 6 weeks of rioting, looting and pamphleteering, most of the establishment, including the royal family, had fled to Canada. A provisional government of revolutionary groups dissolved what little was left of Parliament and declared a new Union of Britain. 15 years later, the Trade Union Congress still forms the centrepiece of politics of the Federated and Democratic Union. The British people are secure on their island, content to build socialism in isolation, protected by the stronger Republican Air Force and Navy, and with each country protected by its own popular militia, who act both as a reserve army and the new police. Now, this here reminds me a lot of the Yugoslavic concept, but regardless. Yet, with the world seemingly ready to erupt into chaos, many are starting to wonder if Britain has a duty to spread the revolution to her former colonial territories. After all, the monarchists in Canada cannot be allowed to plot against the Union indefinitely. You guys need to fix this. Also, still too loud. There we go. Alright, here we go. So, we're going with direct rule from London, and that is the Maximists under Oswald Mosley. Now, I'm going to talk about real-life Oswald Mosley first. My opinion, guys, and this is, again, my opinion, is that out of all fascist-slash-Nazi leaders, I like Mosley the most. And Comrade Mosley calls a meeting. I'll continue again. Comrade Mosley of the Maximist faction has invited George Valois of the French Sorellians, Lavrenti Beria of the former Bolsheviks in Georgia, and Benito Mussolini of the Italian National Syndicalists to Birmingham to compile a manifesto stating their joint aims for a new kind of socialism called totalism. Chairman Snowden's Federationists should keep an eye on this development. Worrying to say the least. So again, out of all the fascist-slash-Nazi leaders, I respect Mosley the most. First of all, a true gentleman. Second of all, he was not an anti-Semite. Even though I'm not a fascist, Kerensky died. I respect Mosley the most. He was a true patriot for the UK. The only thing I will generally disagree with him is the fact that he called Slavs barbaric. Because a lot of the people back then called Slavs barbaric. Well, Sir Oswald Mosley, with all due respect, but, what, 37 years after your death, look at Europe now and please tell me that Slavs are barbaric. Ooh, the Totalist Charter. Mussolini, Wallah, Beria and other interested parties arrived in Birmingham today to discuss their common ground. It has been agreed that Maximism, Sorellianism and National Syndicalism all share basic principles of the state's primacy in the socialist struggle, the role of national identity, exactly, within the state, and the importance of a strong central authority to preserve and build socialism. The Charter also claims the socialist state is the final stage of human development, and that democracy is not necessary to achieve socialism. These statements have drawn great criticism from other socialist factions who gave it the name Totalism, as a play on totalitarian socialism, which has been eagerly accepted by Mosley, who added it to the manifesto's name, attributing it to their total commitment to socialism. All present politicians and philosophers have signed manifest entitled the Totalist Charter, available in all appropriate languages. Boom. All right. Now again, Sir Oswald Mosley, with all due respect, if you could see what the world came to now, what your beloved Britain came to now, I doubt you would call Slavs savages. But yes, that's something that I shall disagree with you. One thing that I will largely agree with you is that you were a man of action, and action is sometimes very, very necessary, because we too often than not get bogged down into the political swamp and the bureaucracy, why did I say bourgeoisie? But Another thing I wanted to discuss about Mosley and why he is such a great thing to add to this mod, and obviously draw parallels from Oswald in this mod and in real life, he is the perfect example of the horseshoe theory. Now, the horseshoe theory says that the farther apart the ideologies are, meaning left and right wing, the closer they are exactly. Because if you take a look at the horseshoe, and for example, fascism or Nazism is on the far right end of the horseshoe. The totalism, in our real life, Stalinism, is on the very left. And they are actually closer to each other than they are to the center. And that is a great example because, obviously, as we know, Oswald Mosley in real life was a fascist, while in this mod he is just the polar opposite. He is a totalist, or maximist, whatever. Jacobins elected in France. The Commune of France is the world's leading syndicalist nation, united as a federation of city communes and directed by the Comité de Salut Public, the chief executive. Ever since its inception, however, the Second Commune was not uniform in its policy. Numerous factions arose, each one with their own idea of which path France should take. As a time for revenge against Germany and the World Revolution closes in, the CGT election of 1936 is set to be very important. The replacement for the disgraced Marsu Pivet arose from the Jacobins, an extremist faction. Oh! Poland declares the Republic, I don't care. So, we have totalists! Yes! Great! Okay, first country falls to totalism, now we all need to hope Mussolini does the same. Because that'd be great. That'd actually be like the best thing that can happen. So the Polish went with the Republic, which is interesting. But yeah, speaking again of Mosley in this mod, I am going to briefly tell you the history. He was obviously fighting in the World War, in the First World War, as we all know, just like in real life. He came back, just like in real life. He became the youngest member of the House of Commons, I believe, and that is the same in the mod. He switched from the Tories to the Labour in, what was it, 21 or 24, I'm not sure, and he immediately joined the extreme left part of the Labour, the Independent Labour Party, and after that, he led a, what was it, not a guerrilla, but he led an independent unit during the British Revolution. So that's why he became like this. He is somewhat akin to Joseph Stalin in the USSR, with obviously our timeline, because Stalin also, as well, was, I think, a leader of one group of or one unit. I'm not sure, and I cannot be entirely sure on that, but I believe something was. Well, I know that Trotsky was the leader of all the Red Army, but I'm pretty sure that Stalin also had some say in that. Right, so remilitarization of Volhynia, and Romania will not give me oil anymore, so goodbye. I shall get my oil from somewhere else. Venezuela, for example. So yeah, that was my two cents on Oswald Mosley as a whole. Now, also, I really like him as a great orator. I am always inspired by orators, and I like looking at cults of personality a lot. I like exploring them. That's why Mosley is such a fascinating person for me to explore. Okay, there we go. Vote for economic policy. The debate has wandered into the area of economics. As has been predicted, every faction has put forward their own suggestion. Most people assume that maximists will win this debate, since Oswald Mosley is a major figure in the British economy. Of course. The economy must be expanded, centralized, and streamlined. Let's proceed. There we go. Also, sorry if I sound a bit different, but I am having a sinus infection of sorts, because, well, my nose is somewhat plugged, my ears as well, so I can barely hear shit. So there's that. Maybe my voice is different. Vote for foreign policy. The debate has wandered into the area of foreign policy. As has been predicted, every faction has put forward their own suggestions, like before. The Congress listened casually to every candidate until the suggestion of the autonomists were heard, when a slow, shocked murmur ran through the hall. So what do they want? They want reconciliation? Pfft, we must fight the reactionaries wherever we find them. Pfft. Military policy. Again, same. The debate is heated since the last few days have only too clearly shown the deep rift within the TUC. The militia, the military must be expanded and the local militias placed under TUC control. Internal policy. The outcome is unsure, since it is where it is here the real decision for the future of the Union will be made. The local governments must be brought in line with the TUC, because we want centralization. And as you can see, Maximus have already taken charge. So yes, Comrade Oswald Mosley is about to take control. Low popularity, that's okay. Let me just see, where's Eric? Eric Blair, there we go. That's George Orwell. Resignation of Philip Snowden. Oh, pause. First of all, Third International. France has gone through with its designs to hold the first Congress of the Third International, and we, as expected, have received an invitation. It would be foolish not to send a delegation. Art Horner will attend on the behalf of the Union of Britain. We shall obviously do that. The resignation of Philip Snowden. On the last day of the TUC Congress, Chairman Philip Snowden climbed up to the podium and made a speech. He claimed that in face of massive rifts within the TUC and due to his age, he intends to resign his post. He also pulled out the cliché time with a family bit that all politicians do. The congregation stood silent as he climbed down from the podium and made his way out of the hall. The country is shocked, and in a few days, the TUC will have to vote on a new chairman. Shocking, to say the least. And affecting officers. In light of the recent demonstrations of political freedom on our island, some royalist officers have defected to us, namely Adam Willis, General Hutton, and Weld Creek hero General Alexander. Oh, nice. They could help the Republican Army and Navy with their expertise. However, while we do not have any proof, there is suspicion that some of them may have fought against the workers in the Second Glorious Revolution. Okay. So there we go, that was that. So Snowden still hasn't resigned, technically. So let's this forward. Chairman election, Maximus secure a majority. The TUC has decided to vote for Oswald Mosley's Maximus with an overwhelming majority. Oswald Mosley will become the new chairman of the TUC. Congratulations, Comrade Mosley. Indeed. There we go, there's that pretty boy. Cynicalism in Spain. Joaquín Ascaso Budría has taken the stage and elaborated the position of the CNTFI in Spain for the Congress. The CNTFI is the largest syndicalist party in Spain, made up of anarcho-syndicalists, moderate syndicalists, and trade unionists. The Spanish revolutionaries have been seeing white terror, violent counter-revolutionary actions taken against workers firsthand. They have come asking for support. We shall obviously support. John Jack Reed and the Combined Syndicates. American journalist, poet, and syndicalist activist John Jack Reed spoke to the Congress for an hour and 15 minutes about the crisis facing the United States and the chance for a revolution in the Western Hemisphere. In the South, the American First Committee is stronger than the central government, and the North is suffering from depression as the West Coast prospers. In the United States, if the United States were to crumble in the face of a revolution, then the exiles would be paralyzed. We will pledge the support for the American workers as well. So we have Jacobins, and we're still waiting on what's going to happen here. These guys still haven't gone with the Fourth Congress, but let's pray for Mussolini. Average popularity. Women's role in worldwide revolution. Yesterday, Helen Crabford took the stage with her flaming speech about women's... Oh, come on. Women's role in the world revolution. According to her arguments, without women's participation in industry and armed forces, it may be impossible to defeat the many enemies of the proletariat. Tempting as it may seem, the political climate in Britain is not ready for such a decision. We need to wait for the Congress of Trade Unions in the fall to enforce the matter. White Terror. We heard joking three White Terror stories. Varian Socialist wanted to delve deeper into the topic of White Terror, and he has been given the floor. After hearing more stories that have come out of Germany, Austria, Hungary, Russia and Finland, the Congress members were ready to make their decision. Another reason: we must end the capitalist system of murder and robbery. We must admit it would be hypocritical if we denounced terror. True, I will go with this simply because both sides make... Oh, we actually may have a chance that Russia turns socialist or communist. Because when they have the Senate, that means they still haven't picked. Bratia Commune asks for support. We shall. Chamber of Princes. Osman Ali Khan. And we have these guys here. Hopefully the... Who's the leader? Subhas Chandra Bose. The Office of General Secretary. Now that a new chairman has finally been chosen, many are urging to quickly choose a new General Secretary and end the period of uncertainty in British politics. Eric Blair will be my choice. Because Eric Blair, obviously, is George Orwell. We're going to have such a nice dystopia in this country. It's going to be marvellous. Alright, so I am going to actually upgrade all my troops to infantry division with artillery. Because I think we will make enough stuff. Alright, let's go speed 5. So we will finish the Congress in 15 days. Congress took a while, you know. What's going on with the United States? They still haven't chosen. What's going on with the United Mexican States? They are still syndicalists. Let's see, what's the chance of totalists being elected in every syndicalist country? We still have to wait for these guys. I'm hoping that Mussolini gets picked. He sometimes does, but bah. Alright, the Congress is over. And so is a lot of our research. So I want to research our Air Force. We need a strong Air Force to deter any attack by the Germans. Now, ooh, look at this. Wow, look at this gun. Look at this gun. I like the look. Obviously, it shows that I don't have the DLC because I'm missing these images. I'm also going to go with paratroopers, and I shall be going with the superior firepower doctrine. Alright, so let's see what do we have here. I would first like to go with mission to Norway. Norway is rife for syndicalism. We could send a team of politically experienced advisors and leaders to the Norwegian Syndicalist Party, bringing pressure on the capitalists and supporting the syndicalists. I've tried this before. Didn't do that much, but I want to try and see if we can overturn Norway. What are the Italians doing? They're still going with the military, so they're still not going for the Fourth Congress. Arab Congress, whatever. Oh my god, the wars over here. Yeah, so far so good. So far so good. What are the Russians going to choose? That's my question. Ooh, well, we're gonna have... We're going to have communism in, also syndicalism in Ukraine, most likely. Yes, we will. Wow. Wow, okay. We're going to have a nice chunk of allies, it seems. If Russia goes with that as well, we'll be fucking OP, man. Siam turns constitutional monarchy. Okay. Prajadhipok. Okay. Nice name. Yeah, these guys are inviting Khrushchev to the government. But they could also go with red resistance. Doesn't mean that they will go socialist. But we'll see. Maybe they will. How much do we need? We need 50 more artillery pieces, and I'm going to start exercising these bad boys. Construction done. Alright. Concentrated industry. Let's go. What are these guys going for? Fill the coffers. Oh, they're actually going with the National Austerity. That's weird. May see war in this part, guys. Popular Front. Yeah, they're going down this side. Collectivization. Yeah. This is going to go down well. I can already see it. What are the Germans up to? Investitions program. Okay. Nice word. Right, so we have sent mission to Norway. I'm going to go with military interventions because I want to be ready to support the CNT and FI, and I'm not sure if I'm going to support the North here because they obviously are too OP. They almost always win. I'll send them all the support I can, but I'm not sure if I'm going to send actual volunteers. What's Italy doing? Still doing the stuff. If they don't choose this soon enough, they're going to get munched up by the Italian Federation. It's not going to be good. But anyway, I think this is it for the first episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed my little talk about Oswald Mosley as a whole. Comrade Oswald Mosley. And as always, I shall see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.